Fenger High School principal Liz Dozier is on a mission to give her kids a shot at a better future.
There's a larger ongoing gang conflict within the community, and like the school, we sit like in the middle of this.
Gentlemen, gentlemen, not gonna happen, not today, not today. Keep it moving, get out of the street. I'm not gonna say it again. Get out of the street.
He's headed southbound on 112th and Emerald. Principal down, and I broke my shoe. Can you send someone for me on 112th and Emerald? I broke my shoes.
An important part of Principal Dozier's job is to keep tabs on gang conflicts and make sure her students are safe at school. By the time a kid gets to high school, his gang affiliation can become his identity, and even a lunchroom fight can turn into a gang war.
Who was the other girl? I need you to go down there and get that.
Principal Dozier and her team have transformed the culture at Fenger High.
Ladies, it's too loud. It's too loud.
There are two kids arguing. Let's figure out what the issue is, because if we don't get to the root of it, it will continue to bubble up until it will explode.
In 2009, Fenger was identified as a failing school that needed to be saved. Principal Dozier was hired and given broad authority over an entirely new team. She also received a 4-year federal grant to help turn the school around.
The climate in the school was just absolutely abysmal. Like massive gang fights in the hallways, 300 arrests that first year. We had to have literally 2 districts worth of police in the building for us to be able to change classes one day. It was a scary time in terms of like, what's happened to our children?
There was a shooting a couple blocks from the school. But we got a couple calls saying a lot of our kids are up there.
They're my kids. I feel like, you know, worried, panicked, like, you know, who is it?
You know, I've lost kids before. Something happened to one of them and it was because like something that we did or didn't do or something, I would just die.
The work is not between like the hours of 8 and 3:30. To me, it extends beyond that.
Schools become like these dropout factories. And it really has to do with issues that are happening at home that no one's really addressing at the school, because this is really the last stop for 98% of the kids here. Like, if we don't get them off into something else, like, there are no other options.
Liz's hard work with her students hasn't gone unnoticed.
Where Fenger was 4 years ago,
and what you've done today,
is what I firmly believe.
There's a new Fenger, because there's a new principal.
This is not really a black issue, it's not a white issue, it's not a Latino issue, it's not a South or a West Side issue, but it's really an issue of our children's lives and fighting for their lives. And ultimately, I really believe the fate of our city and our country. So I say to my staff and my students who are sitting right over there, welcome to the age of possibilities, because we started from the bottom and now we're here.